Good afternoon. I am really nervous because I have a whole lot to do, so maybe I won't get it all right. But because I'm nervous, I guess the first thing I ought to tell you is my name is Jeff Brinks. I'm the pastor here at St. John's. It's great to see all of you. Also, because I'm nervous, I probably need to tell you, if any one of you needs those rooms that you might need sometimes when you're nervous, if it's on this level and you go out the back door here and down the ramp and out the back door, the bathrooms are back through there, should you need them. We are in for a wonderful treat this afternoon. We have a lot of divine voices singing some sacred music, and so really, really looking forward to that. And at this time, I want to invite some of those sacred voices to come up and, so to speak, assume the position. Would you please pause with me for a moment of prayer? Gracious God, we thank you for the gift of music, that it moves us and stirs us and encourages us to be better people. We ask that you bless this time, bless this offering of music, and bless our listening to it. And be with us, for we ask this in the name of our Lord. Amen. It is with great joy and pride that I present to you the director and founder of Sacred Voices, Mrs. Susan Fricker.
It is my very real pleasure to introduce Sun Min Lee from Lehigh University. She is the associate conductor of the university choir. She is the director of Dolce. She's a very dear friend, and she is a marvelous conductor. So, Sun Min Lee.
Good afternoon. All right, it's your time to sing. Good afternoon. What a fantastic sound they were making. Wow, that's great. Thanks for spending your Sunday afternoon with us. It's beautiful outside, but beautiful inside here as well, right? Great, good audience. On the behalf of Dolce and Lehigh University Choral Arts, we thank St. John's Church of Christ, UCC, for inviting us to perform in this special concert. And we love to sing for this great audience. So we are so delighted to be here. Lehigh's Women's Ensemble, Dolce, is composed of undergraduate and graduate students majoring in all types of fields. Some of them are double majoring, right? Raise your hand. Yes, they are. And some of the majors I can't even talk about because it's too long. Anyway, they're great. By any chance, are there any Lehigh alumni here? If you're here, hello. Hi. Yes, excellent. Thanks for being here. Oh. Okay, great. Wow, it's going to be a great afternoon. Huh? Our first two pieces will be sung in Latin. The first one translates to "Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous ones." And the second one is based on a chant melody, translates to "Where charity and love are, God is there." It's a beautiful two pieces of motet. I hope you enjoy it.
Oh,
This performance at St. John's remarks our first concert of the season, 2015-2016. In other words, we have a lot of freshmen in this room or in this group. They had only 4 rehearsals to sing for you. Aren't they great? So, I guess I'm too brave to bring them out here, but they've been doing great. I'm so proud of you. You guys sound great. So, next piece will be sung by our returning folks who are in the middle. Thou Shalt Know Him, nice hymn setting, followed by quite interesting, I think you're going to agree with me, quite interesting Gloria by Benjamin Britten.
Thank you.
one of those pieces that you can dance, but you don't know how to move it. But I hope you had a little fun moving your some hand or somewhere your body part. Okay, all right. What am I saying that here? Last May, the Lehigh Choral Arts had a very successful concert tour in northern Italy. Say, yeah, we had a great time. It was truly amazing to perform in many historical churches with very enthusiastic audiences. Am I right? Yeah, we had a great time. The next piece we are about to sing, The Lily of the Valley, we still have a very vivid memory and very fond memory of singing in St. Rita Church in Padova. Was it Padova? What? Torino, sorry. Yeah, I just changed the city. Anyway, so it's so wondrous music, and we would love to share that with you. So this is Lily of the Valley.
Oh,
at this time, I would like to invite Susan Fricker to come down here and standing next to me. She has no clue, of course not. Susan, how many years have you been with the Lehigh Choir? So how many years? Yeah, let's do math, 7 years. Yeah, 7 years. And as you all know, Susan is an incredible musician and devoted church musician and a lady with endless energy. Who agrees with that? Everyone agrees? She never rests until it's perfect. But she's just dear my friend, and she's been just a blessing to us, and I'm sure for this congregation, this concert. I was actually in that in the balcony 2 years ago listening to the choir, and it's great to be front up here and acknowledge my friend whose birthday is today. Oh! So would you please join me singing happy birthday to her? Yeah, we like surprises. All right, this is our final song. We close our program with I Got a Home in That Rock. I Got a Home in That Rock. Arranged by a recent Lehigh University alumnus who is here, Casey Rule. Hi, Casey. Thanks again for being here and spending your afternoon, and it's an incredible opportunity for us, and we are thrilled you are here, and we are thrilled that we can sing for you. It is a very valuable time of yours. So until next time, and also there are the concert schedules at Lehigh University, our choir will be singing the Vespers and upcoming concerts. Please look at it, and we would love to see you, right? It's not that far, right? So hope to see you in Baker Hall or Patrick, what is it? Chapel. Yeah.
I got a home in that rock, don't you see?
Thank you so much, Dolce, for being a part of my celebration. You are such great singers and such wonderful young women. Our country's in good hands. I guess when it's your birthday, you're allowed to reminisce. So I'd like to tell you how I became a church organist. I was lucky to grow up in a house that was filled with music. My mother was a singer. My dad was a whistler. And I had piano lessons at the age of 5 and started getting weary of practicing by 6th grade. And my mother said, how would you like to learn to play the organ, the church organ? If you keep your practicing on the piano going, I'll see if I can get you a teacher in organ. So that's how it happened. So by the time I was 14, I had been playing Beethoven sonatas on the piano and Mendelssohn sonatas on the organ, and I was feeling pretty good about myself. And we had a very small Moravian church that I grew up in, and the organist was a pianist who taught himself to play the organ. So his left foot sort of gravitated toward a note once in a while, that kind of thing. Wonderful man. But one day I came home and I said to my dad, and he was reading the paper, I said, Daddy, if our organist plays the Green Cathedral one more time as a prelude, I'm going to scream in the middle of church. And he said, you think you're pretty good, don't you? And I said, yeah. He said, okay, let's see you get a job. So we opened the newspaper to the classifieds. Now, I have to tell you, churches don't advertise for organists in the classifieds. They just don't do that. That's not done. It's not the best way to do it. But there it was. Trinity Lutheran Church in Topton, Pennsylvania was looking for an assistant organist. And so I called the number. It never occurred to me, I'm 14, I don't drive. How am I going to get from East Allentown to Topton? But my dad was very good-natured, so I made the appointment. I found out what I was going to have to play for them. And my organ teacher, who was a Lutheran organist, was thrilled. He brought the old red book, the SBH, to my lesson, and he said, okay, you're going to have to know how to play a chant. You're going to have to know how to do this. Moravian churches don't chant. You have to know how to do this. Well, we figured it out at one lesson. I was prepared. I was great. Oh, I'm going to walk in there. I'm going to get this job. So the day came, and of course, my whole family went. There wasn't a lot to do in those days. Remember, this is 1965. there were 3 channels on the TV, so, you know, there wasn't that much to do. So the whole family went with me to this interview, and I was feeling really great, and I walked in. Now, if anybody has ever experienced this, please tell me, because I have never seen this in my life except at this point. When I walked into the church, every organist who was interviewing for that job was standing there. And there were about 18 of them. It never dawned on me there'd be other people that wanted this job. And that they'd all be older than I was. So I looked around. Well, the youngest person was 18. She was the church council's president, the president's daughter, church council's president's daughter. And she was taking organ lessons from the organist of the church. And I thought, oh boy. The rest of them were experienced organists. I thought, what was I thinking? I must have been out of my mind. And just as I was thinking, you know, maybe I better just sneak out quietly, a voice came in my head. And the voice said, no matter how well you play today, if God doesn't want you here, you're not going to get this job. But if God wants you here, nobody's going to be able to stop you. Well, a feeling of peace came over me, and I really enjoyed the interview. I really enjoyed the audition. We were told in about a week, the committee will make their decision. If you're chosen, you'll get a phone call. If you weren't chosen, you'll get a letter of thanks for auditioning. So it was getting late that afternoon on a Sunday, and we decided to stop for something to eat. So we did. When we walked into our house in East Allentown, the phone was ringing. It was the pastor. I had been unanimously selected as the assistant organist. So I learned a valuable lesson that day, and that is that God is the one that's in control, and that from God comes all good gifts. And I've felt a call to church music ministry ever since. And it's been 50 wonderful years, and there are people in this congregation right now that are from some of the churches I have served. So if you are in, or if you're one of the churches that I've served, would you just stand up so we can say hi? I know there's some people here from Emmanuel. I saw some other people. Yep. Look up, look up, look up. There they are. Hello, hello, hello. These wonderful people have sung in my choirs, And of course, you can't be a church musician without lots of volunteers to sing and to do all kinds of things. And I felt so supported all these years, and especially from St. John's and St. John's staff. So I want to thank you for a wonderful 50 years. I thought it might be a good idea to play something on the organ, since I'm actually celebrating being an organist for 50 years. So I'm going to treat you to a piece by Franz Liszt. It is based on B-A-C-H, the letters of Bach's name. In Bach's time on the German organs, B was a B flat, A was an A, C was a C, and H was a B natural. So it's ba 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 is what you're going to hear. He based an entire fantasy and fugue on just those four notes.
Thank you. Okay. Will Sunmin please come forward? Sunmin Lee, would you please come back up front for a minute? Oh, she's okay. Great. And mom. Oh, and your daughter. The choir wanted to thank you for everything you've done for us and for being with us in this great event. So we brought you. And now, to Susan, or my mother. This is for you, and a very special gift from the choir, which I hope you'll like.
The card says, the love of Jesus shines through you. God knew what it would take to make a wonderful difference in the hearts and lives of people. That is why he chose to use you. Thank you for all you do to shine for him. Congratulations on 50 wonderful years of music ministry as you have shared your faith, your joy, your talents, and your passion for beautiful music with all of us. Thank you for another wonderful season. Happy anniversary. Love, St. John's Sacred Voices. Thank you.
And thanks for everything you've done and for your anniversary.
Thank you very much. Okay.
And the gold is for your 50.
I guess I'm not supposed to open it yet.
You can, actually.
I'm supposed to open it? These poor people are standing here.
Should I help you? This is very...
Okay.
It's just torn on. There you go.
You better sit down. All right, come ahead. This could take a while.
No. Tear it. Just tear it.
Grief.
All right.
Good grief.
While you're helping there, we also want to acknowledge Becky.
Oh, thanks.
It has my name, and it's in honor of your 50 years of music ministry. It's a beautiful box, and it's got a little baton. Isn't it cute? Oh, my goodness.